Ethiopia has severe challenges with land degradation, soil erosion, poor soil fertility, increased acidity, aridity, salinity, and loss of natural ecosystems are widespread. Human-induced factors and natural calamities consistently threaten the country's biodiversity.
The situation has resulted in a vicious circle of low productivity, food insecurity, and poverty.
Regenerative agriculture is a farming approach that aims to make agricultural land more productive by improving soil fertility and boosting biodiversity and ecosystems as a vital aspect of food production. The goal is to increase ecological, social, and economic resilience with low environmental footprint.
I used to repeatedly plow my plots, which caused the rich soil to erode. Due to a lack of access to better seeds and fertilizers, smallholder farmers would consistently plant the same crop variety using the same seeds. Even I don't know how to use available fertilizer correctly because I only broadcast a little bit on a weedy plot and neglected to control weeds in a timely manner.
Sasakawa Africa Association is promoting sustainable and regenerative agriculture as a way out of the country's intricate problems of low agricultural productivity and environmental degradation.
Sasakawa Africa Association, SA, has prioritized regenerative agriculture as one of its key strategic pillars. SA promotes regenerative agriculture through conservation agriculture and integrated soil fertility management practices at both farm and landscape levels. Farmers and extension agents are taught about reducing tillage frequency. To ensure this, an improved plow is being promoted. SA also encourages retaining and returning crop residues after harvest back to the field for mulching and using cover crops to avoid leaving the soil bare. To increase agrobiodiversity, SA promotes crop rotation practices
such as cereals and legume crop rotation,
intercropping, and agroforestry. The integrated soil fertility management approach that SA promotes includes proper and efficient use of inorganic fertilizers through proper sources, application rates, time and placement, while at the same time using organic materials such as compost, vermicompost, decomposed manure, farmyard manure, green manure, and biofertilizers to improve soil fertility and health.
Priority duties for Sasakawa includes determining the target location's soil status. Soil samples are taken from farmers' training centers and host farmer plots, and they are examined in conjunction with agricultural research centers to determine nutrient levels and soil pH. Based on the results of the soil analysis, acidic soils treated with lime.
In addition to using diverse local cultivars, SA recommends using improved crop varieties that are high-yielding, climate-resilient, and tolerant to pests and diseases, while simultaneously promoting good agronomic practices.
We learned several good agricultural practices of regenerative agriculture from Sasakawa, such as reduced tillage, improved composting, crop rotation, intercropping, leaving more stubbles in the farm during harvesting and letting the crop residues to decompose, and crop diversification. In addition, mulching helped us to control weed and increase yield.
To address the adverse effects of climate change, SA has set up climate smart villages to improve livelihoods and increase adaptation to climate change among the rural poor. At these climate smart villages, water efficient technologies, climate smart practices, and climate resilient crops are demonstrated to achieve the triple goals of increased productivity, climate adaptation, and mitigation.
As a result of the knowledge that we gained from Sasakawa, we have eventually improved our agricultural production. There has been a severe shortage of water in our area, where SAA taught us how to harvest and use water for irrigation, roof water harvesting from tankers, and delivering water to plants with simple and inexpensive drip irrigation tubes.
SA encourages smallholder farmers, especially women farmers, to practice permanent gardening known as permagardening at home states to address household nutrition requirements and improve their incomes.
To improve my family's nutrition and health status, I will expand permagardening and continue to produce more vegetables even during the dry season.
In addition, Sasakawa encourages crop and livestock integration by promoting high biomass crop varieties and incorporating fodder crops in intercrops bonds. That notwithstanding, encouraging transitioning to regenerative agriculture by smallholder farmers has been an uphill task. Changing farmers' attitudes towards abandoning over-tilling, crop residues removal, free livestock grazing, poor soil fertility and water management, soil erosion, and low regard for conserving natural resources are some of the challenges. Furthermore, sectoral coordination, stronger integration of crops, livestock and natural resource management, and a lack of land use policy must be addressed. For regenerative agriculture to succeed, farmers should lead the design and implementation by integrating indigenous practices with current scientific knowledge.
Sasakawa supports this transition to regenerative agriculture by way of building the skills and knowledge of farmers, agricultural extension agents, as well as other actors across the value chain. Our aim is to enhance the agricultural productivity, profitability, and income of farmers while maintaining and enhancing the environment.
Regenerative agriculture necessitates policies that support and encourage farmers, such as input-output market incentives. Sasakawa is committed to working with all food system actors to support such efforts. Sasakawa Africa Association, working with the farmer.